Hey there, Josh Pitka, flying at you with just an encouragement. Really have on my heart to take a few minutes, like literally 2-3 minutes, and encourage you, especially if you're a youth or a young adult. Now, to me, a young adult, anyone from like 14 to 35, you know, maybe you're not married, you're still kind of figuring out career, you're figuring out where you're going. But the most important thing that you could ever do is completely surrender your all to Jesus Christ. We're starting again a Friday night youth and young adult ministry, and I'm calling for some leaders. I'm calling for some people that want to give their all. And the scripture that God really put in my heart and for this little video message is Hebrews 12 verse 1 and 2, and it says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses," and that cloud of witnesses is referring to the people of faith that laid down their life for the cause of Christ in generations past. Okay, it's talking about people, history makers, the radicals, the ones who they didn't just live for themselves and their own pleasure or something like that. They lived for the kingdom of God. And so we're surrounded by this great cloud of witnesses. Paul says in Hebrews 12, "Let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us." So Paul doesn't just say lay down sin, he says lay down every weight. In other words, everything that weighs heavy on your heart, everything that you know you can't have and have the fullness of God. And we all know what those things are, but it's sometimes difficult to lay everything down because you know you still, you feel like, well, it's in my rights. It's like, oh, Friday night, youth and young adult. There's lots of things going on Friday nights. But usually things that are going on Friday nights, if it's not God stuff, it's going to be a weight that's going to hinder you eventually from the high call that God has on your life. You know, just a few moments ago, I started a moving company. I was doing closing a deal, and I just felt to go back and present the gospel to these people and got to pray for them and got to bring some healing to the guy's shoulder. It was just powerful what the Lord did. But you can't do stuff like that if you have weight in your life, if you have things that aren't of God weighing you down. You can't operate in the supernatural. You can't, you know, you can't be that history maker, that person that God has called you to be, running the race with endurance that God's called you to run, if you have weight and if you have sin or things in your life that are just hindering you. And so the appeal is this today. Would you be one that would lay down their life for a lost and hurting generation? I mean, I walk around this city, my city of Sarnia, Ontario, my little corner of the earth, and we have broken people walking around that need the healing presence of Jesus. Maybe you're watching this and you need the healing presence of Jesus. And I want to be an instrument today that would, even through this video, would just flow through the airwaves and it, you know, beyond time and space, and it would flow through, and that the healing presence of God would touch your heart today. That's my prayer. And that He would awaken you to the call of God in your life. It says, "Looking unto Jesus," verse 2, "the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before Him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God." And then verse 3, I'll say that as well. "Consider Him who endured such from sinners, such hostility against Himself, so that you may not grow weary or faint-hearted." So I want to encourage you. I'm calling out some leaders. I'm calling out some people. I'm going to send this around to like just some people that I've known or people that I just, you know, God put you in my heart. I'm sending you this video. And the appeal is this. Would you give your life to Jesus Christ? And if that's so, just pray with me right now. Say this with me. Lord Jesus, right now, right here, I give you my life. Come into my life. Invade my heart. Invade my life. Just say that out loud. Lord, invade me. Lord, I give my heart to you. Fill me with the Holy Spirit. Separate me from all sin. Separate me from every weight. Give me a holy boldness to preach the gospel of Jesus. Give me a hunger for the things of God. I open up my heart to you. I'm saved, I'm born again, and I'm living for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. And I want to invite you to be a part of what God is doing at Dunamis Church on Friday nights, on Sunday mornings, and to be a vibrant part of a community is just so important. God bless you. Hope you enjoyed this little clip.